Okay, so we're always talking about manifesting things, right? Like, how do I manifest this, that, the other? But why do we even desire things at all? We desire things because our current level of consciousness desires to transcend itself. We want to feel better. We want to feel higher and closer to our truth, which is our highest self, our soul, or the God that lives within us, right? So simply put, we desire things for the feeling that that thing is going to bring us. Of course, desiring specific things is not bad. You deserve your desires and you get your desires for a reason. But we also need to understand that the root and the foundation of why we desire things is because we want to feel better. We want to feel happier. We want to have everything in our life working out so that we can feel safe. We can feel happy, secure, abundant, loved, supported. All of these things. These are all like the root and the foundation of why we desire the things that we do, right? So there comes a point on our journey when we're constantly desiring things, but we need to come back to ourselves and ask ourselves, how about manifesting emotions? How about manifesting moods? How about states of consciousness? How about being happy? How about living in the miraculous world? That's what we're really here to do. That's what we're truly seeking. And by doing that, we then manifest every other thing in our life when we're just focused on the feeling of having the feeling that we want to have when we have our desire. Okay, that's what this video is about. I'm going to talk about how we can reach that feeling without yet having our desire, and how having that feeling, reaching that feeling, actually can get us to our desire. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Rahoza, and if this is the first time that you're seeing my face, then welcome. It's so nice to have you here on the channel. This channel is the place where I will remind you of your creative power that you possess, because we were all created to create, and I truly, truly believe that whatever it is that you desire, your wildest dreams that you could possibly imagine are possible for you. They exist out there for you, and receive the full fulfillment from your desire, and not just have it come into your life and be a fleeting desire, and you're onto the next, the next, the next. I believe that we can live a life of pure happiness, and things get to be good. Life gets to be good. Life gets to be fun. So I want to share with you, before I get into today's content, two things. Number one is my book called Becoming a State Shifter. Now, Becoming a State Shifter is an accumulation, really, of a lot of the things that I'm going to be talking about in this video today. It's a short book that I wrote all about living in the miraculous world. Not just achieving one thing over here, manifesting one thing over there, but living in a state of pure happiness, which attracts everything to you. So if you want to read this short book, then I will leave it in the description below for you to check out and purchase. And also, super exciting news is that I am starting a new container called The Seed. And basically what The Seed is, it's a 1-day live Zoom event that I'm going to be hosting on the first Monday of every single month, starting this May 1st. And we're going to get clear on what our intentions are for the month. And we're going to share those intentions. We're going to make that declaration out into the ethers, out into the universe, of what it is that you want to call into your life, the goals and the action steps that you want to take, and really support each other, hold each other in that space of achieving your goals. I'm going to be there to hype you up, support you, and hold that space for you. So I really hope to see you there. There's going to be more information on this offer in the description down below. Make sure that you sign up before the spaces all fill up, because I do want this to be like a close-knit container of women. Okay, so let's get into today's video. So as many of you guys may have studied or know or heard about Neville Goddard's teachings, you may have heard of the concept, isn't it wonderful? So this video is kind of like my little spin on isn't it wonderful. Now, the concept that Neville shares of isn't it wonderful is amazing, so I'm going to share that with you. Basically, Neville Goddard had a student where her entire life, everything was just out of alignment. She didn't have anything. She didn't have money. She didn't have a partner. She didn't have any friends, any relationships. She was homeless. She basically had nothing to her name. And she was just struggling in every area, including, of course, mentally. So she was a student of Neville Goddard. And instead of giving her specific affirmations, specific things to desire, like affirmations to repeat and affirm, I desire a house, I desire a partner, I desire money, I desire this, that, whatever. Instead of going into detail on exactly every single thing that she desired, which could be endless, right? We constantly are desiring new things all the time. He gave her this one simple phrase to say and affirm on a loop. And that was the words, isn't it wonderful? Now, isn't it wonderful is great, because what it does is it doesn't condition your desire for one specific thing. You're not saying, isn't it wonderful that I have money, that I have a relationship? So you're not conditioning it to having to be any specific thing. So what this does is it leaves it open to you being able to catch the feeling of wonderful things are just happening. Isn't it wonderful that everything amazing happens in my life? So that is the purpose of saying this blanket statement affirmation of isn't it wonderful, is because it leaves it open. It's not conditioning to your specific thing, but leaving it open to, I'm open to any amazing thing happening in my life. I'm open to beautiful things coming in through all different directions that I may not even be able to see or understand right now because I am limited by my human perception and I don't know how the universe and divine is going to flow and align my life perfectly to manifest and call in my desires. I don't see that. As you know, I do have the God that lives within me, but I am not the totality of God. I am limited to my human perception and ability. So this concept is amazing, but I wanted to share just how I put my little twist on it, because for me personally, like, I personally don't say, isn't it wonderful? It's not like a part of my vocabulary. It's not a part of what I say in my day-to-day life. Like, I'm not just like, isn't it wonderful? Like, that's just not, I just don't go about my wording like that. And you may be similar, like, it's not really a thing that we say. So what I started to say instead were things like, I have everything. My life is perfect. Everything just works out for me. I get everything that I desire, right? These are all simple blanket affirmations that you could use. And it's just different variations of really saying and implying the same thing, which is that everything is perfect. Things are amazing in my life. My life is good. Despite what I'm seeing right now in my external reality, in my 3D circumstances, I maintain speaking out the affirmations and thus feeling the feeling of things just being good in my life. Ultimately, the point in saying these affirmations or affirmations in general is to catch the feeling. With persistence, with repetition, it then infiltrates into our subconscious mind, and that is what creates the feeling within us. The reason we want to catch the feeling is because whatever we desire to manifest, we desire it because of the feeling that it's going to give us. So if we feel the feeling that it's going to give us now, we feel the feeling of amazingness happening in our life and things that just feel good to us, we're calling that in. We're aligning ourselves with good things happening. This is what alignment is. This is what raising our vibration is getting ourselves in the state, in the feeling, in the knowing, in the feeling of good things just happen to me all the time. Remember that your life, your external world, your 3D world is going to constantly be outpicturing your internal world, your daily consistent thoughts. You know, I can give you a personal example for me right now. The past like month and a bit, I was in a bit of a funk, okay? Full transparency, I was not feeling my best. You know, I've been saying the affirmations, I've been doing the self-concept work, I've been drilling in these things into my mind, getting into the feeling state, but we're still human beings. Okay, let's not ignore the fact that life has ebbs and flows, and that's a part of the human experience and why we're here on this earth. That's something I really had to learn and kind of humble myself to. It's like, okay, I can constantly drill in these affirmations again and again and again, but that's not gonna stop the feeling that I'm feeling right now, which is I'm not feeling inspired, I'm not feeling aligned, I'm not feeling like my best self, and I almost don't even wanna keep affirming for the things that I want in my life because I just don't feel good. So right now I want to just focus on manifesting feeling good. So I took this upon myself. I took this challenge upon myself to say to myself, you know what? I understand that this is the way I'm feeling right now. I'm not going to completely, you know, invalidate myself, my emotions, or suppress my emotions, because that's not what we want to do either. Because when we suppress our emotions, that's actually what's going to manifest, because it gets trapped in our body, and our body is our subconscious mind. And whatever's in our subconscious mind is going to outpicture itself in our world. So I understood that I needed to allow myself to just be here, process the emotions, feel what I needed to feel, and alter my desires accordingly, alter my approach accordingly. I understood and allowed myself to be in an ebb, because I know that we need to have an ebb in order to flow. This is the ebbs and flows of life, the ups and downs of life. So this doesn't mean that even though I'm saying to you today, you know, say the phrase, isn't it wonderful, and you're going to attract beautiful things. Yes, it's true, but that's not to say that we're not going to have ups and downs. I'm not going to sit here and say this line and you're going to feel perfect 24/7. No. And you could say, okay, that's a limitation, but that is the reality that most human beings are living under these conditions. on a daily basis, right? We have ups and downs. We have wavering thoughts. We can continue to redirect, and just constantly live in this masculine approach of continuously affirming until we catch on to the feeling or until we get our desire. But at the end of the day, we want to also be flowy with it, right? We want to feel good in the process of manifesting. Manifesting should feel natural, should feel abundant, should feel flowy. So when I talk about saying these affirmations and affirming to ourselves that life gets to be amazing, that life is beautiful, that we get everything we desire, it's to keep our dominant thoughts and our dominant focus in the life that we're creating, because that's where we're going to dominantly live, right? 99% of the time, we're going to call in and experience these amazing, beautiful things happening. But then, of course, there's going to be that 1% of the time where ebbs are going to happen. Life is going to bring us ups and downs. We're going to be a little bit knocked off of our routine or our momentum or our desires, or something's going to happen in the external world that's going to shake us. Like, that's the reality of it. That is the reality of why we're here in this human experience, is to go through these cycles. But sometimes it's going to take that initial discipline to bring ourselves back on the track of, let's remember our truth here. And the truth is that amazing things are constantly happening for us. The reason we don't see it is because our focus is not predominantly on it. So the main point I'm trying to drill into this video is, let's change where our dominant focus is in. Isn't it wonderful? Isn't it amazing that beautiful, amazing things happen to me? You start drilling it in. At first, maybe you don't believe it. Maybe that hasn't been your current reality up until this point. Or maybe you do have some evidence, but you're still in a low place, or you're in a funk and you're not feeling like your best self. Know that initially, when it comes to anything, when it comes to a goal, when it comes to manifestation, it takes that initial discipline. Just like we have physical muscles we need to strengthen, we also need to strengthen our mental muscles. We need to repeat over and over again these phrases that we want our life to become, so that it infiltrates into our subconscious mind and then manifests itself into our reality. It's a process. But through persistence, through consistency, through time, we begin to see our life completely shifting. We begin to live more in the miraculous world. And I talk way more about the miraculous world in my book that I wrote called Becoming a State Shifter. But we really want this to feel like a natural process for us. But we also need to hold that duality and understand that sometimes it's not going to feel as natural when we're in an ebb, but we have to hold that state of mind. Like, while we're in an ebb, while we're in a low place, we need to still remember that everything is going to turn around. And we say these affirmations over and over and over again to reaffirm this new identity that we're creating, to solidify our self-concept, to raise our consciousness to a level of not just calling in the things that we desire physically, but how are we feeling on a consistent basis? We don't just need to manifest things, because that's not always gonna bring us the fulfillment that we're seeking. We're also here to manifest our emotions. We're here to change ourselves out of this negative state into this positive state. And this is a journey, this is a cycle, this is a practice that you will continue to practice and embody more and more over time. I'm gonna end this video off there. I hope that you got a message that served you. Like I said, if you're interested in joining The Seed, which is that one-day container that I'm hosting live on Zoom on May 1st, and then hopefully from there, it's my intention that I host one on the first Monday of every single month. So you can click the link in the description box below where you'll see more information on that offer. I'm so excited to hopefully welcome you in there, hold that space for you, and connect with you on a more personal, intimate level, and support you on reaching your goals and desires in the month of May. May is the month that you're going to receive everything you desire. Don't ever forget it. Okay? That's all for me in this video, guys. I hope you got value out of it. If you did, please leave it a like and a comment down below letting me know what was the most valuable thing you got from this video. Hit that subscribe button for new videos every Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday. And without further ado, I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Love you.